Hello guys, New Apple Times here, welcome to a new video, and today I'm gonna show you how you can shoot RAW photos or videos on your iPhone. Okay, so if you don't know, RAW is a photo format that is the most used by photographers because it's an uncompressed format. So basically, when you see JPEG or PNG or even HEIF, which is what the iPhone shoots in by default, those formats are compressed to take up less storage, but of course in that process some data is lost. This can be more or less noticeable with the final photo, but if you pretend to edit that photo, the RAW image will give you all the data and then you can edit it and export it to either compressed format, but the quality will be much bigger. That's why most cameras that are just made for taking photos will shoot in RAW. And even for video, it's basically the same thing, however it's harder to find RAW video cameras. But Apple with the iPhone 12 Pro introduced the capability to shoot RAW photos. That has continued in the Pro models ever since that, and in the iPhone 13 Pros they allowed the capability to shoot ProRes, which is one format for a RAW video. So yeah, to be able to shoot RAW photos or video, you will first need to activate the formats in settings. Therefore, you need to go to settings, then scroll all the way down to camera, and then at the top you will see formats, and then you have to enable photo capture for Apple Pro RAW, and if you have an iPhone 13 Pro or 14 Pro or higher, then you will see the video formats page, and that's where you enable Apple ProRes. Now again, this is only available in the Pro iPhone, so if you have an iPhone 12, 13 or 14, you won't see either of these. Then, if you go into the camera, you will see the RAW icon there, and you can enable it per photo or disable it. And then for video, it's the same. You will see the ProRes icon, and if you enable it, you will get the ProRes video on the RAW video, and if you don't, you will just get the normal compressed video. This is especially useful because for the iPhone 14 Pros, this is the only way to shoot the 48 megapixel photos with the sensor. However, do take into account that these photos and videos take up much more space than the regular ones. So it should already be used if you really, really want to get the whole quality of one photo, or even if you pretend on editing that photo or video later. For example, you might have seen that when I switched to ProRes video, I have this warning saying that I can record only 45 minutes. My iPhone is 512 gigabytes and I currently have a bit over 300 gigabytes, so you can just have an idea of how much storage this takes. But yeah, this is gonna be everything for me today. As I said, super easy trick. If you have any questions at all, please let me know down below in the comments and I will do my best to answer. And also, if you found this video helpful, I would really appreciate it if you would thumbs up. Lastly, you should consider subscribing if you like Apple, because that's exactly what I post. I post all types of Apple tutorials and content, unboxings, reviews, etc. So if you don't want to miss any of that, you should subscribe. But yeah, thank you very much for watching and see you in the next one. Bye.